Aloha Brandishers, how have you guys been doing? I've been doing great apart from some minor allergies, so please don't mind if my voice sounds like that of a man. So since this is the end of June, we guys decided to give you a monthly favorites video. So amongst the three of us, we will be reviewing 4 products each, so that is 12 products in total. Let's start with me first. So the first product that I want to talk to you guys about is the Colorbar Ultimate Nail Enamel Remover. It's an amazing product that I discovered this month itself. So I've been using acetone all my life for removing my nail pain since my parents are doctors. But lately I kind of developed an allergy below my eyebrows to acetone. So when I visited my dermatologist, she told me that I needed to give up nail paints altogether, or I should use a nail paint remover which was free of acetone, and same goes for nail paints. So I went into the market and started looking for such products. I came across this at the Colorbar counter. It is dermatologically tested, it's acetone free, and it's an amazing product, you know. If you open the box, I'll show you. It's got styrofoam inside it. This is something which I've been using since the last month, and it's been always giving me consistent results. The lady at the counter told me that I would be able to use it for around 4 to 5 months, which is a long duration, you know, because I'm a very heavy nail paint user. The next product that I want to talk to you guys about is not something that I discovered this month. This is something that I've been using since 2 years now. It's the NARS Orgasm Blush. I think it's the most popular blush in the world. I wrote that in my post too, and I, like a million other girls in the world, swear by it. It's this beautiful peach color, and it's a very warm color with a little gold shimmer in it. It gives you a beautiful sun-kissed baked look, which I really love. I use it for all my day looks. Some good dupes for the NARS Orgasm Blush are, there's this peach blush from Lakme, which you guys can try. I haven't tried it personally, but I've been reading some very good reviews about it. And there is a peach colored brush in MAC as well. I don't know the name, but if you were at the counter, the lady will surely help you out. The next product on my favorites list is the Victoria's Secret Color Flash Eyeshadow in Flirtatious. This was a gift from a friend, and I've been again using it since forever. It's this beautiful pale pink color with shimmer in it. I've swatched it for you guys to have a look. So the best part about this eyeshadow is that once you use it on your eyelids, I've used it right now, it does not leave a garish pink color on your eyelids. It's very subtle, and it takes the color of your skin tone, so it leaves a very warm colors. If you have a look at a lot of pink eyeshadows, you'll see it. They make your eyes look very frosty, which I don't like so much. In this case, again, the skin tone of my eyelids is very warm, which I love. So this is one eyeshadow which I use for all my day looks. This is my second box now, and but unfortunately the only problem is that it's not available in India, and I haven't been able to find good dupes for you guys. Like I said, it's very difficult to find good eyeshadows, pink eyeshadows, in the market. So if you guys have any suggestions for me for pink eyeshadows, I'd love to hear them from you. Did you guys notice something different? Yeah, I just changed my lip color and came. That's because the fourth item on the list of my favorites is MAC's Relentlessly Red. Now this is a beautiful bright red color, which I totally fell in love with last month. I have always been a sucker for red colored lipsticks, and before this I was using MAC's Ruby Woo, which is again a beautiful color. It goes on every skin tone, and it's a beautiful color, but it is on the maroonish side. I wanted something which was brighter because I've got a fair skin tone, so I thought a bright color would suit me more, and I was right. This color is something which has been very flattering, and I've been using it to literally all the parties I've been to this month. So for all of you who love bold lip colors, I would suggest this. This is a beautiful color which all of you must have. That was my favorites, you guys. Let's go on to Shreya now.
Hey Brandishers, here are my favorites for the month of June. The first one that I want to talk about is the Tory Burch perfume. It is absolutely like spring in a bottle. And I'm not kidding. I'm a person who really likes bold fragrances. I'm not a person who likes citrusy or floral notes. But this one was a pleasant surprise to me. It's bold, classy, and very, very refreshing. I love waking up to this every morning. The other reason why I actually bought the smaller bottle, the roll-on, was because this was $20 and the bigger bottle was for more than $60, and I wasn't ready to make the investment until I was absolutely sure that I really, really liked it. But this one I would absolutely recommend to every one of you out there. It is an absolute spring favorite, spring and summer favorite. And my second absolute favorite for this month is the Makeup Forever White Eye Pencil. I've actually blogged about this a couple of times as well, and I've even used it in my pictures. But the reason why I'm actually recommending this is because I've realized that the moment you put this on your waterline, the pictures come out to be absolutely gorgeous. So the light actually reflects and makes your eyes look much more brighter and bigger, which makes your photographs look absolutely beautiful. It's really, really easy to use. It wasn't really expensive. I think it's available at Sephora. And Makeup Forever is an amazing brand. Most of my makeup is actually from that brand. I would absolutely recommend this to anyone. Sometimes I actually use this when I haven't had a very good night's sleep, and I know that people the next day are gonna ask me if I was really tired or stressed, so I just put this on my waterlines and it just makes me look that much awake. And I love this, absolutely love it. My third favorite of the month is the Bioderma makeup remover. I absolutely love this. I've actually used a couple of makeup removers till now. They either make my skin really greasy or really dry. I have sensitive skin. It's kind of a combination. Sometimes it gets really oily and sometimes it gets really dry. So the only makeup remover that has actually worked for me is the Bioderma one. It's just like water. It doesn't have any irritants in it, and I've been using this for almost a month now. I have a smaller bottle. I actually got this in my top box, but I think I'm gonna actually get a bigger one once this gets over. I absolutely love it. I think the place where I actually use my makeup removers is especially to remove my eye makeup, because you generally can't use face wash and it just gets really messy. And you don't want remnants of your previous night's makeup to be there for your next day, because it's just gonna look really bad. So all I do is I put 2 or 3 drops on this cotton pad and I just sweep it across, and it just cleans beautifully. I've never had any issues. It's never irritated my skin, even if I felt that a few drops have actually gone into my eyes. So I would definitely recommend this as my number 3. So my fourth and last favorite is the American Cream from Lush. I absolutely love Lush products. I think they do a great job. And you'll hear a lot about Lush from me because I absolutely love that brand. The reason why I like American Cream is because my hair are extremely frizzy, especially in the summer when it gets really humid. This is the only thing that actually works magic for me. So the only thing that you have to do for the application of this is that you rinse your hair with shampoo and then you take a considerable amount of this and put it ear down on your hair and just leave it for 5 minutes and just rinse it off. It's that simple to use, and a few washes you'll actually see a difference. I actually had the smaller bottle initially and it worked really well for me, and that's why I got the bigger one. And the smell, guys, is really, really amazing. It smells like strawberry vanilla, so the moment I always use this I feel like going for an ice cream. That's about it from me. Let's see what Vithi has to say for hers.
Aloha Brandishers, moving on to my monthly favorites, first of which is Soap & Glory's Dr. Spot Acne Gel. This product worked wonders for me recently when I was having a lot of trouble with my skin, with breakouts all over my forehead, on the side of my skin. It was particularly bad on the sides because it kind of made my skin darker from the rest of the face, which annoyed me a lot because I had not had this problem in my life ever before and I didn't know how to deal with it. So I went to Sephora and asked a representative there to help me with a product that would address this problem of mine, and she suggested this one. And I brought it home, and the kind of results this gave me was just amazing. I just needed a tiny dab of it on each of the breakouts that I had and slept overnight. And the next morning, all the spots had dried up.
So for the kind of results this product gives you, it's great value for money, and I just love it. And this is my holy grail now for dealing with breakouts. I know Soap and Glory is not yet a very popular brand in India, but it is a very good brand from the United Kingdom, and you can find it at Sephora outlets in India. My second favorite of the month is Fake Up Concealer by Benefit. You knew that was coming, right? I think people who know me would probably faint if they didn't find a mention of any Benefit product in my favorites video. So yeah, this is an amazing concealer, great formula, very creamy, so gets onto the skin very nicely, and it has light to medium coverage. For me, this has worked really well under the eyes and also for my crease lines, especially on my laugh lines and around the nose. And consistent results that it has given me has earned it a place in this video. My next favorite is the Maybelline Hooked on Pink color. It's the number 065, and it's a very nice pinky brown color, not so much brown as much as it is pink. So I really like this. I like such shades for daily wear, and it's a very wearable color, so you can wear it to office or on a normal day out with your girls. It's Maybelline formulas are really great, and you can just put them on, they don't dry up, they are quite hydrating, though I like to put on a layer of lip balm first before I go for this one, and I'll just swatch it for you as well for you to have a better idea of the color. That's how it looks. So the next product is the final favorite of this month, and I don't think my favorites would ever be complete without the mention of this particular product. It's a very special buy for me because my husband bought it for me on my birthday, and it is one of my most amazing makeup products that I own. It's a beautiful pink highlighter called Rose Diamond by Dior, and it looks like this. Even in packaging, it's one of the prettiest things I've ever seen, and the results it gives is just amazing. How much it perks up your cheeks, it's beautiful. Sometimes I just use it as a blush with the darker side of the palette on my apples of the cheek, and it just gives the most beautiful results, a very healthy pink glow on the skin. Looks very natural and perfect for days when you want to wear something really light and not heavy, especially on hot summer days, you know. So yes, I would really recommend this. I know this is a very pricey product, but I wanted to cover everything from, you know, a drugstore range to a high-end range for people who like to try everything. And yes, this will definitely be one of my most satisfactory high-end buys. That's it for this video, guys. Hopefully it gave you some inspiration to try out some new products that we mentioned, or let us know if any of these have been your favorites too as well in the past. Give it a big thumbs up if you liked it, and subscribe to our channel below to keep track of our new videos that we make every Sunday for you guys. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram, and links to all our social media websites will be given in the description box below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next Sunday. Meanwhile, keep brandishing!